You talk about how the beasts are powerful creators. And I understood that from a point of them being free, basically being free of any resistance.
Mostly they are. And you can domesticate them into resistance, and sometimes you do, but right. Mostly they are resistance.
But here I'm mostly thinking of, you know, beast, wild beast.
Yes.
And I took that thought a little further and think, well, if indeed they are that free of resistance, then shouldn't that make them even more powerful creators than we are, since we are so full of resistance?
Yes, it does. But they've come with different intention than you have. In the same way that they are freer of resistance, they also focus less upon desires. And that's really the distinction. You have the potential to focus your thoughts in more deliberate creation than the beast does, which is the reason that you have greater resistance. It's like the baby, even the human baby is resistance-free for the most part, but this little baby doesn't focus deliberate creation like someone longer in their body either. It's the same sort of thing. So the perfect life would be to have the focused mind of the genius human and the absence of resistance of the wild beast.
So then the distincting factor is intensity of focus.
Focus without resistance will bring you whatever you're focused upon. And the intensity of it has to do with how much you care about it. And so we are really enjoying your train of thought here, because so it seems, could it be possible then that I could really, really, really want something in an absolute resistance-free state of being? And we say, it's possible, but you usually have to work your way into it, because the way you came to want it so much was because you honed it from the contrast.